So before we get too far along in this Fox Pro Predator hunt, what you're about to see may be disturbing, especially if you believe that aliens are real and perhaps dangerous. Okay, now let's go coyote hunting. So I'm in New Mexico and I'm filming with my buddy Cade. He loves calling coyotes. We're a few miles from a place called Area 51. If that rings a bell, then you probably know where this is leading. The hunting was pretty slow, but we did manage to call in a few coyotes. It was sketchy calling them here. They'd been called a lot, and they were pretty shy to the call, but the Fox Pro dug a few up for us. So after Cade missed one, he pulled a double on two others that came to the call. Cage's in a 17, and boy, does he like that gun. It drops them in their tracks. So we were about to pick up the last dog when there it was. Best I could tell, it was nearly a mile out and moving fast against the wind. Glistening in the sun, it kind of looked like it was made of aluminum, but it was trucking pretty fast.
What is that?
I don't know what it is.
I have no idea what that is, but it's freaky looking, whatever it is.
At first I thought maybe it was a balloon, but it was trucking against the wind. That definitely couldn't be the case. Eventually, it was out of sight. So Cade needed to change his underwear, and I decided to go hunt bobcats with a guy named Jesse. Jesse is the world's number one cat man. Or should I say, cat dog man.
Folks, we're fixing to have a lot of fun today, and speaking of which, here comes Jesse now. Runs a lot of walker dogs, and he's got some of the best cat dogs in Texas that I've been around. I've hunted with him four or five times, and they're just unbelievable.
There's Jesse and all his friends. This is Jesse, folks. He has a little trouble with people, but he gets along with dogs like you can't believe.
That's right.
He's got the best dogs in the world. This one's got a lazy eye. He obviously got into it with a lion. How's conditions today for
it? Ought to be good.
What do we need to catch cats? What are you looking for? What kind of weather?
Low barometric pressure and moisture.
Okay. Yeah. We're getting that today.
Yes, sir.
All right. Well, this will be the first ever, if it goes our way, and I can hit the mark, and the dogs can tree a cat. A lot of things got to come together. Our guide, I'm a little worried about him because he's got a ponytail, but I think he's got a reputation for putting people on stuff, so. Anyway, this could be a first ever blowgun kill for a bobcat. This could be cool.
It's gonna be cool, yeah.
All right, well, let's get started, and this is gonna be wild.
Let's go.
Well, the light's just starting to come up early in the morning. Had a good sleep last night. And Terry, tell them a little bit about these bobcats and your chickens and all the other animals on the ranch.
Well, I mean, it's just a typical South Texas ranch. We have, javelinas, hogs, deer, coyotes, bobcats. The bobcats are kind of hard to catch. They're pretty smart. They're pretty elusive, and the conditions have to be right. And I think today they're going to be just perfect. Reason why Tim's here is, first of all, he's going to blow dart one for the first time, but we're trying to get rid of a few of the predators here. I have chickens, and I have some dogs, and I have farm animals around here, and my bobcats are kind of trying to deplete all of my resources, so we're just doing a predator hunt.
This is the part they've been waiting on here, just to get out of the box.
Oh, That reminds me of the circus clowns coming out of that little car.
That's right.
How many of them are there?
I had 12 in there.
All right, I need to know all 12 of their names for the show.
Oh, come on.
Come on, give it to me.
I got Abby, Banjo, Drummer, Tina, Tammy, Whistler, Hondo, and Sam.
That's awesome.
That's
and Terry.
And Terry,
okay. they're already off and running. Look at them going down the road. Well, hopefully we strike a bobcat. We're going to save a chicken today.
Woo.
Kill a bobcat, save a chicken.
Save a chicken. That's what I'm all about. I love my chickens.
Turning on all the GPS equipment to track all the dogs. It's got bird's eye view of the roads, senderas, creeks.
We got a tracking collar for
Terry. We need a shock collar for
him. I'm pretty feral, but you know, I can find my way back to the truck.
They're just trying to catch one bobcat that's crossed the road within, 6-8 hours, maybe?
Yes, sir.
We had a couple deer cross the road in front of us, and the dogs didn't even put their head up and look at them, so they are trained to solely chase bobcats. So we just loaded up the dogs. We ain't been hunting for 15 minutes. We suddenly looked at the tracker. We forgot Banjo. He's just at the house running around in the yard. We gotta go get Banjo.
Took her 5 years to get one to eat out of her hands.
It was hard to believe that he forgot Banjo, because Banjo's like Jesse's son. But a couple honks on the horn, and here he came. Jesse's dogs have treed over 1,000 cats, many of which were problem lions. Mountain lions, that is. Jesse knows every dog by its bark.
Drummer opened first, and then Tina opened.
The dogs have lost the first cat's trail. They got pretty hot, so they came out for a drink.
They've been after this cat for about a half hour, and they're trying to figure him out because he doubling back on them and circling. They're on the trail where he might have been hunting last night, but now they've straightened him out, and you can see that the pack is on his trail and they're running him hard.
We're hoping to thin out the bobcats, for they ate 10 of Terry's laying chickens in the last month alone. And Jesse could tell that, finally, they must have treed the cat. He can tell by the sound of their voices when they tree or when they're chasing. That's javelina, and they'll kill a dog if the dog approaches them. But Jesse's dogs know better. They won't mess with them.
They hit the track, so they just opened up and started to bark. Now more of them are barking.
Yep, there he is. And what a bonus, for they've treed the cat not 20 yards from the road. The dogs bay the cat while I slide in under him. I'm sneaking through the brush, looking for a clear shot. I want the perfect angle to make a clean shot to its heart or lungs. The dogs have done all the hunting, so I will merely be finishing off what they've started. Bobcats are beautiful creatures, but like wolves or coyotes, they can create an imbalance if they're not kept in check. And on this ranch, there's far too many. The cat continues to watch the dogs as I move in the final distance. That was quick clean kill right there. He's dead now, caught in the tree, but it took the dart about 15 seconds to kill the cat, and I got my bobcat, but he's lodged into the tree now. Whose responsibility would that be, Jesse?
The man that shot him.
Oh, really?
Yes, sir.
I thought we went by age.
No.
I am a good tree climber. I think I can do this, Terry.
Myself.
Okay.
Either one of us.
It's a different experience for me anyway. Calling cats is one thing, but treeing them with a dog has been very unique. It sure was a great first experience, and to see the dogs in action and see how well trained they are. And Jesse has got quite an amazing group of animals here. That's like family to him. He's the best in the world at it, and it was a pleasure of mine to be able to tree my first bobcat and kill it with a blow dart. And not a long shot, not a tough shot, 10 yards up in the tree, but I got my first bobcat with a blowgun. It's been quite a day.
Okay, let's knock him down.
Cats are tasty critters, and their fur is beautiful.
What do you say, Jesse?
Don't get no better than that.
What is that, number 1,000 bobcat for you?
Yeah, pretty close.
All right, and what a beautiful pelt. Oh boy, look at that. My new blow darts are deadly. They're razor sharp. When I put it on the package that I say they're razor, I mean it. They'll cut you. So when you want to hunt with them, you want to take an animal out as quick as you can. And the most ethical harvest with a blade runner is anything that's razor sharp. And I strive to get my broadheads on my blowguns as sharp as possible.
Do you own a blowgun or spear? Well, slockmaster.com is where they're sold. We've got the best razor darts, blowguns, fishhawks, and spears right here at slockmaster.com. They're just too much fun. Pick off a squirrel or rabbit while you're waiting on a deer, and bring home some hossam pepper for dinner. So check us out at slockmaster.com.
I'm having the time of my life. Give me a blow gun and send me in the woods, and I'm as happy as a little kid in a candy store.